Okay, so welcome to Dominion Nocturne, What's in the Box, Part 4. If this is the first one you've watched, and you skipped to the first three, go back to the first one and watch the first one before you watch this one, please. Alright, let's get started. Okay, so, in the last video we had just explained the moth and explained why the moth would give you a caterpillar, etc., etc. And so now we're going to show you what the caterpillar does. So, with this is another knight card, once again. So, you trash up to two cards from your hand. If you trashed at least one, exchange this for a moth. So, basically, the caterpillar, you know, before it can become a moth, and I say caterpillar because that's just what I decided to go with. Technically, all butterflies are in the moth family anyway. There's more. Anyway, so this caterpillar here, it's going to become a moth. Okay? That's the point. Anyways, so you exchange this for a moth if you trashed at least one card with this card. But it allows you to trash up to two if you want as well. If you don't trash any cards, then this is going nowhere fast. But in reality, if the caterpillar is going to be eventually become a moth, it first has to eat a lot. It definitely has to eat a lot, and then before it is ready to go into its cocoon and obviously build itself a cocoon. And then that's what happens. It basically goes into its cocoon for a short period of time, and then the next time you get this card, after it's been, shuffled from your discard pile into your deck, you've got your moth back. The caterpillar has become the moth. Then the moth dies, lays a bunch of eggs, and then you get one of those caterpillars from one of those eggs, basically. So sort of thematic in the sense that, that these two work together real well, and just, that made it very interesting for sure. So I'm like, we need moths. Moths are nocturnal. So let's do that. Okay, alright, so, now let's go over the cards that are not in the supply that work with a variety of cards, like the Naturalist, and the Ferret, and the Raccoon, okay? And obviously, you saw the Gecko earlier, but the Gecko obviously goes with this one too, so, the Naturalist. So anyways, let's go over these three first, starting with the owl. Okay, so this is an action knight card. So if you choose to play this during your action phase, you will not get to play this same one during your knight phase. So that is something to note. But if you wait and you're patient and you wait for your knight phase and play this during your knight phase, that's interesting too. Now, when you think about it this way, this is where it really comes in handy for the knight phase. Let's say you're playing a bunch of cards, and you draw a bunch of cards. Like, let's say you play Smithy, and you draw three cards from the base game, right? Well, let's say you didn't play a village ahead of time, and this was one of the cards you got. But now you've run out of actions, and so therefore you can't play this during your action phase. But however, you have a knight phase. So then you're like, oh, it's not a complete waste, because now I can play this during my knight phase. Alright, so let's go over the action phase of the card. So you get plus two cards. Then you may play an action card from your hand you don't have a copy of in play. So that's kind of cool. I like that aspect for sure. And then at the end of your buy phase, if this is in play, you actually may put it into your hand. So that's another thing I added. So when I replaced a card with this, I completely added that as well. So that's new as well. So then you can continuously keep playing this, which is pretty cool. But that is interesting, for sure. So you'll definitely be, obviously, getting to play this a lot. So that's another thing I liked about doing it this way. You'll always have an owl around, and you can continue playing it. But, like I said, if you have a turn where you don't have plus two actions, or plus one action, and you decide to play this during your action phase, after you put it into your hand, because if it's awesome effect, then maybe you'd be better off holding it off and then just playing it during your night phase on your next turn instead. So that's like an alternative way of playing it. But that's just an option. Alright, and otherwise you'll just keep playing it over and over throughout the game. So if you get a bunch of these, which I wouldn't recommend getting a bunch of these, because then you'll have nothing but owls in your hand. So, obviously that could be counterproductive. But then during your night phase, you may put an action card, put an action from your hand back on top of your deck. So the reason why this might be useful during your night phase is, let's say you weren't able to play all your action cards, and so you have a lot of action cards sitting in your hand, and during your night phase, you can put another action card from your hand on top of your deck for your next turn. So that's kind of an interesting alternative way of getting to play some action cards that you might not have played. Now, I can't say that this is the best card I've ever replaced or created for that matter, but it is still kind of interesting for sure. And it's definitely not the worst. Alright, then we have the Fruit Bat. And this is a card I actually ended up just simply creating on my own. So this doesn't even replace anything that's actually in the game. Now, yes, Nocturne had Bat in the game, but I didn't like what it was paired with, so I ended up getting rid of it. But I'm like, we still need a bat. And so you remember my flavor text, a bat eating an orange in the flavor text. If you watched the flavor text video, then you remember that being in my flavor text. And so here's a bat, well, eating an orange. So I didn't just, you know, come up with that out of the blue. All right, so you may put up to two treasures you have in play on top of your deck in any order. At the start of your next turn, you get a plus buy, and then cards cost two less, but not less than zero. This is very powerful. However, it can be difficult to get at times, and there have been times where I'm like, I have three choices here. I could choose to gain a card and then get the owl, or I could choose to gain a card so I can get a skunk, but if I do that, I can't get this. And then by the time the raccoon comes around again, the game's half over maybe. And I'm like, do I still want to get the fruit bat? Maybe, maybe not. So, there actually haven't played this too much because I don't, it always seems to be the last one I go for. And that's why I did it that way. So that way, you'd have three different options when you played with the raccoon. Usually, with the original card that it replaced, you gained a gold as one of your three options. And I was like, let's make it more interesting. Let's make it more, maybe even complicated even. And make it more likely to make you think twice before gaining something. When it wasn't really much of anything. You're like, oh, well, I'm just going to gain a gold. I'm not going to get anything this turn. I only have two money. I'm going for the gold. I'm not buying anything at all. You know, and so that's what that was. And that's what I did with this card. I just changed that up a bit. But like I said, this card is new. There's nothing like it in Nocturne. All right, and here's another card that has nothing like it in Nocturne. And look, I'm sure you noticed the purple as something that you only see on curses. And that's true. Donald has never made any official cards as of yet that are minus point cards that are like curses. At least with this color banner. There are some cards that give you minus points, but they don't go into your deck. But this does go into your deck. And it is minus 2 points. So, if you remember the other video with the naturalist and you trash an estate and you gain a skunk and a gold, well, this is what you're getting. You're getting a minus point card, a minus 2 point card, but you're also getting a gold in the process. Is it worth it? Maybe, maybe not. But it also is an attack card too. So then you can give each other player a wasteland as well. So you play this as an action card to give out wastelands, but it's also a 2 point minus card. You certainly don't want to get stuck with it, for sure, but, you know, that's why the raccoon is like usually why you don't usually go for the fruit bat, because each other player gains a skunk if you gained two cards. So that's why I did it that way. So you wouldn't gain the fruit bat very often, because most players, they like their attack cards, and this is like a knight attack card, because if you gain two cards, each other player gains a skunk. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, the skunk, a minus point card. So Anyways, and this obviously wasn't in the original expansion, obviously. Now, before this video ends, I wanted to go over another card that adds three cards that are not in the supply. In fact, these three cards are not even in this. They're not even accessible. They're sitting in your trash pile at the start of your game. Yes. Now, obviously, this replaced cards that actually do exist. But I, you know, decided to make it more realistic. So this is the junk market. You get a buy, you get a treasure, and then you play a non-duration action card from the trash, leaving it there. And then the setup. So there's another card with setup on it. Put the three heaps into the trash. So what are the heaps? Well, these are the heaps. The scrap metal heap, the wood pile heap, and the trinket heap. With the trinket heap, you get a card, you get an action, you look at the top card of your deck, discard it, or put it back. With the wood pile heap, you may trash an action from your hand. If you do, plus three cards, and plus one action. And then with the scrap metal heap, trash the top card of your deck. You may gain a card costing one more than it. So, that is all of the cards in the heaps. And then the junk market that gives you the heaps. Is that good? Not really. I didn't really like the cards I replaced. I didn't even really like the cards, what they did as well. But I kept it because it was definitely something that you don't see anywhere else in Dominion as of yet. That's why I decided to come up with this idea to replace the cards that it used to be, which were zombies. Once again, not down to earth. There's no zombies in real life, at least not yet anyway. So, and I don't think there ever will be either. All right, well, that's it for this video. We've still got a bunch of stuff to show you in Nocturne, so we'll continue on in the next video.